Hello everyone, today we are going to talk on the topic Order 7, Rule 11 of the Code of Civil Procedure 1908. So what is Order 7, Rule 11? Order 7, Rule 11 talks about the rejection of a plaint. So among other rules under Order 7, Rule 11 states that various grounds upon which the court can reject a plaint. Though it is to be noted that rejection of plaint is different from return of plaint. That is under Order 7, Rule 10, where the court finds that it does not have the jurisdiction to try the matter before it. The court returns the plaint to be presented to the proper court, which holds the rightful jurisdiction. Whenever an application is filed under Order 7, Rule 11, the court, before moving forward, needs to evaluate the said application and determine whether the plaint is admissible to be instituted or not. In the case of Salim Bhai vs. State of Maharashtra, held that for the purpose of deciding an application under Order 7, Rule 11, only the averments in the plaint are germane. That pleas taken by defendant in written statement at the stage is wholly irrelevant, and that the direction to file a written statement by the trial court without deciding on application of Order 7, Rule 11 would be nothing but a procedural irregularity. There can be many grounds on which a plaint can be rejected. Some of them are: where a plaint does not disclose a cause of action, it's under Rule 11, subclause A. Cause of action, though, has been mentioned in plenty instances under CPC, but isn't defined under the code. Merriam-Webster dictionary defines it as the grounds such a violation of a right that entitles a plaintiff to bring a suit. In other words, cause of action is the fact or combination of facts that provide an individual with the right to seek judicial redress against another individual. Order 2, Rule 2 of CPC makes a mention of cause of action in the context that generally the whole of the claim has to be made under the given cause of action, because one can't trouble a party twice for the same cause of action. However, if the plaintiff chooses to not include the part of claim, he can do so at his will, but later on can't sue for the same claim he previously omitted from the suit. Whereas subsequent suit was found on the cause of action. Second position where a plaint can be rejected is where the relief claimed in the plaint is undervalued. It's under Order Rule 2, subclause B. The plaint presented has the claim undervalued, then the court can prescribe a time frame within which the relief claimed has to be correctly valued. Failing in doing so, the court can reject the plaint. Though the correct valuation, the plaintiff can file a fresh suit under the Order 7, Rule 13. Another place where a plaint can be rejected is where the relief claimed is properly valued, but the plaint is written upon paper insufficiently stamped. As the case may be at times, the relief claimed is properly valued by the plaint is written on the paper but is insufficiently stamped and authorized. The plaint is liable to be rejected if the person is unavailable to present the court with the requisite stamp paper. However, if the requisite stamp paper court fee is paid within the time extended by the court, the suit or appeal must be treated as instituted from the date of presentation of plaint or memorandum of appeal for the purpose of limitation as well as for the payment of court. Another place where a plaint can be rejected is where the suit is barred by law. It comes under Order 11, subclause D. When it appears that a suit so instituted is barred by any other existing law, the plaint for the same shall be rejected. For instance, when a person entitled to institute a suit or make an application for the execution of a degree is at the time for which the prescribed period is to be reckoned a minor or insane or an idiot, he may institute the suit or make the application within the same period after the disability has ceased. Another point where a plaint can be rejected is where the plaint is not filed in duplicate. That comes under Rule 11, subclause E. Under the Rule 4, under the Order 4, Rule 1, plaint is required to be filed in duplicate. In the absence of the same, plaint is liable to be rejected by the court. Another place where plaint can be rejected by the court, where plaint fails to comply with Order 7, Rule 9, In case the plaint fails to meet the requirements specified under Order 7, Rule 9 of the code, the plaint shall be rejected. Another